experience. If you have a nightmare, suppose you were sleeping, you're fast asleep and dreaming. You thought the elephant has come into your bedroom. You got terrified, and out of that fear you woke up and there is no elephant. Even though there is no elephant, you will still sweat, you will palpitate, you will go through everything as if something happened. The moment you woke up, you know it was just a dream, but still you fear. So, when we say a dream, don't take it lightly. A dream has more… is more impactful than reality for most people. So, the trap of a dream is not a simple trap. It's a very powerful trap, self-created, especially because it's self-created. You have no means to break it, because what you have created, there is a certain sense of attachment and liking to it. You can't break it. Have you seen at different stages in your life, some silly little things which are in your drawer? You know it's no use, but you can't throw it away. Even if it's causing some trouble, you can't throw it away because… just because it's been there for so long. There is a certain sense of attachment to it. So what you create, it's very hard to break it. It takes clarity of perception, or it needs outside help. Otherwise, it could take a very long time. Long time, when I say, I'm not talking in terms of years, it could take a very long time. Allowing outside help, asking for outside help, or even if it comes unasked, allowing outside help needs a certain gracefulness, needs a certain humility, otherwise you can't allow outside help. Lots of people cannot receive something gracefully. And always the social ethics have taught you giving is important, taking is not important. Yes, taking is not important, taking is ugly, but receiving is very important. If you do not understand that you anyway, everything that's worthwhile in your life, you're actually receiving. I want you to just look at any aspect of it. Right now, the clothes that you wear, for this cloth to sit here right now, here, do you know how many things and how many people are involved in delivering this here? Somebody planted a cotton seed, that plant growing up, a million organisms were involved in making this plant grow up, and then the cotton, you know the whole process in Tamil Nadu, from ginning to weaving to spinning to weaving to everything, how many people? And then the cloth, and then the maker and the seller and the agent and everybody else. And now here, it's sitting here. How many thousand people are involved in just this cloth sitting on your body right now? The food that you ate, for it to get into your system, how many people and how many different lives have participated in making this happen? None of these things you could do all by yourself, isn't it? If you understand this, and if you receive this gracefully, you will be overwhelmed with gratitude. If gratitude becomes your very life breath, you will also become very receptive. When you are grateful, you are very receptive. You can only be not gratitude as a certain, you know, people have always told you three magic words, one of them is thank you, not a cultivated gratitude. Gratitude happens to you when you are overwhelmed by something or somebody. Suppose you were very hungry, very, very hungry, you thought you were going to die. Somebody just gave you a piece of bread. Now tears of gratitude will come to you. That same piece of bread, if they gave you a loaf some other time when you're well, it wouldn't have meant anything to you. But at that moment, that piece of bread, when you look at that person who gave that piece of bread to you, enormous gratitude, because you're overwhelmed by the experience. With every aspect of your life, if you recognize how much is involved to make a single aspect of your life happen, a piece of cloth or a piece of bread, a morsel of food, what it takes for it to be created and to land on your plate and get into your body, if you just see from microorganisms to human beings, how many lives are participating in making things happen for you every moment of your life. If you are conscious of it, if you peel your eyes and look at it properly, you are overwhelmed with gratitude, because you could never do this by yourself, never, never, never do this by yourself. If you are overwhelmed with gratitude, you are in an extremely good state of receptivity.